maybe one issue. Other than that, you know, it really wasn't the car's fault. It was Infiniti dealership. They didn't install the AC compressor correctly, so, you know, that's when I got stranded up in Georgia at Z1 Motorsports. But other than that, we'll just jump into the build and what I've done so far. So as you can see, the first thing is the InnoZetec Millennium Jade, aka Hunter Jade, wrap done by Konpeki Auto Detailing here in Tampa. You know, it's supposed to resemble the Nissan manufactured Millennium Jade paint. And as you can tell, it is a pretty damn good job of matching that Millennium Jade. By far, I am so pleased with how the color came out. I was pretty scared on how it was actually going to look, and it actually came out a lot better than I was expecting. Get a lot of comments on it. And other than that, it just, you know, you don't see a lot of, you know, Millennium Jade, Hunter Jade cars, and, you know, other than that, it's just, it really goes well with the Infiniti body lines on the Q60, and with the black Ray 57CR Nismo wheels that I've had for quite a while now. These wheels, I've been eyeing these ever since my buddy Caleb had them on his 370Z Nismo back in Colorado. Been super pleased with them. Honestly, I haven't got sick of them at all. I've had them on the car for about 2 years now. I do, you know, I get a lot of comments on Instagram to upgrade my fucking brake kit. I do know I probably need to do that soon, but I got the R1 Concepts brake rotors and pads. You know, the rotors, they just look good. But that's something on the list to do in the future. It'll be a big brake kit, Akebono, one of the big brake kit from Z1. Other than that, on the exterior as well, carbon fiber duckbill lip. Bought a guy off Instagram. I think it's just an eBay spoiler. Does the job. We got a carbon fiber diffuser with a third brake light. Sheesh. That back end. And then, you know, we got the carbon fiber M3 mirror caps to pull off that, you know, BMW look. You know, because us boys want to be fast like B58s. And other than that, we got a three-piece front lip. You know, I used to have a carbon fiber lip, and then, you know, I hit something on the highway going about 70 and busted it. So I'm not wasting any more money on, you know, $600, $700 lips and have them break, you know, possibly every 6 months. So other than that, we'll get to the performance, what I've done so far. Really not a lot. We got AMS lower down pipes, tagged with the AFE Dakita exhaust cap back, which, in my opinion, those two paired together get you the best sounding VR30 exhaust setup. What's this? Pros to this car, I was would say, you know, if you really take care of the car, do your regular maintenance, the car's going to take care of you. If you don't fucking beat on it in the middle of summer when it's 100 plus degrees and don't let it cool down, or, you know, your oil change is over 5,000 miles every time, you know, that's where you're going to come into issues. And everyone's like, oh, the VR30's not reliable, blah, 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 whatever. You know, I've had one issue, and that was it, and it wasn't even the car's fault. So, you know, really, other than that, I've been super pleased with the car. Another pro, I think, compared to the Q50s, are the body lines on the Q60, I think, are more pronounced and just, you know, just gives you more sports car feel. I know it's a coupe, but, you know, just the body lines on the car alone, I think, just take it away. Number three pro, I would say, would be, you know, for the amount of mods you can put onto the car to the horsepower that you get out of the simple mods, such lower down pipes, exhaust, tune, you know, you can get to 450 wheel horsepower, you know, non-red sport, red sport, whatever, you know, so really, if you want to get something quick and just do a couple mods to get you to 450, I think it's probably one of your best bang bucks besides, you know, B58 where you get downpipe and tune. But other than that, cons, really, honestly, right now for me, just my damn insurance, but that's just probably me living downtown Tampa. I don't know how other people's insurance are for, you know, their payments or whatever, but honestly, really, I don't have a lot of cons to the car. Really, maybe the interior, you know, everyone thinks it's outdated. You know, I'm not a big interior person anyway, so it really does not have a big effect on me. Interior mods, really, nothing crazy in here. Just got some Dyna Performance, you know, carbon fiber accents, just some overlays. Super cheap. Was sponsored by them for a while, but, you know, they never really send me shit anymore. So, I just got those just to clean up the interior a little bit. You know, just got some shit. And then my boy Andrew over A to Z Customs. If you guys have seen my first video I ever posted on YouTube, it was a paddle shifter install kit. My car is a Lux, so it did not come with paddles. So this was a, you know, kit that I found on Instagram, A to Z Customs. Came with the paddles, wires, and the column, and a super easy install. So if you guys want to go check out that video, I got the custom blue paddles, and I fucking love them, man. If your car doesn't have paddles, I would go hit up Andrew on Instagram for sure. Makes it a lot more fun driving the car, and just a lot easier than using, you know, the middle shift knob. So, you know, other than that, really, the interior, nothing crazy. Probably get maybe a carbon fiber steering wheel down the road from my boy over at A to Z Customs as well. But other than that, nothing crazy. So that really just leaves the future plans of the Q60, which, as you guys, you know, you guys watch my other videos, you guys know that I have the upgraded VR30 turbos from Z1 Motorsports. Won that in the raffle at Z Nationals this year. So this upcoming year, 2024, the plan is to get those installed and get tuned and see what numbers we can push out of this thing. So other than that, really, it's really putting those on tune. And other than that, maybe get some coilovers or switch to air suspension. We'll see. I'm still going back and forth on which route I want to go. I'll probably just end up going coils. But other than that, that's really it. I'm super pleased with the car, where it's at right now. Possibly just adding some light, you know, exterior mods. I've always wanted to get a car. lights, just to, you know, change up the exterior look a little bit, but really, other than that, I've been super pleased with this build. Over 3.5 years, almost 4 years of having this car coming up in April next year. So, honestly, if you guys are in the market for a Q60 or even a Q50, I would recommend for sure. The Q60, you get that coupe feel, the sports car feel. Q50s, I mean, they're great. You just see them on the road a lot. Your grandmas, your grandpas, your moms are all driving them. I see some moms and stuff, some older ladies driving the Q60s. Nothing wrong with that. Just, you don't see a lot of them around. But other than that, I do recommend, a lot of people, if you go on forums and stuff, you're always going to see the negative stuff on forums. So I always kind of advise not to go on the forums to look on, should I buy, not buy, this car? Because you're just going to get the negative people. They're going to be like, oh, this car sucks, it's unreliable, went through 3 turbos, blown motor, blah, blah, whatever. And I've gone through some bad cars. Like, I had 2 Subarus, one Subaru blew the motor twice, another Subaru blew motor, transmission was going out, clutch went out twice, so, but I beat on those fucking cars. I do beat on this car, but not to the extent I did on the Subarus, just because I was young and dumb and didn't fucking care. Like I said, just take care of it, do your regular maintenance. I get oil changes about 3 to 3,500 miles, each time. Just keep the oil, nice and liquid, but other than that, guys, that's pretty much it. If you guys want to see anything else, or you guys want any recommendations on, upcoming videos, go ahead and leave me a comment, and, we'll just go from there. So, other than that, future, Lily, fiance, she, over there in the scat pack, my body kit came in with the wheels, so we'll do an unboxing video as well on that, and, we'll do the install video to that as well. So, appreciate y'all tuning in on this video. Hope y'all liked it. Leave a comment, like, subscribe if you haven't already. Appreciate the love always and the support. Catch you on the next video.
The robbers, I was just trying to give me some dollars. A couple dollars, turn my pennies from hundreds to commas.